Hello everyone and welcome to NewsClickin. This is Anushka. This is a new show that we are bringing to you called The Daily Roundup, where you'll get a glimpse of some of the news stories that NewsClick has covered. So let's take a look at some of the top stories from the day. On Monday, the body of a police officer was left hanging out of his black SUV after he was attacked with stones and allegedly shot dead by a mob in Bulandshahr. The trouble started after some villagers found carcasses of cows in a jungle. Angry villagers and members of various Hindu groups brought the animal remains in a tractor trolley to the Chigarwati police chowki and demanded action against the culprits. They blocked off the Bulandshahr-Garh highway and raised slogans against the police. The protest soon turned violent with protesters pelting stones, injuring and killing one villager and Inspector Subodh Kumar Singh. Inspector Subodh Kumar Singh, the police officer who was killed, was also incidentally the first investigating officer in the Dadri lynching case where Mohammed Akhlaq was killed over alleged beef consumption. He was taken off the case in November 2015. All the 18 accused in the Dadri case, some of whom have links with the BJP, are out on bail as the hearing in the case is still on in the city courts. The recent Kisan Mukti March held in the capital did not see any representation or involvement from the BJP. However, one of the BJP ministers instead went on to criticize some of the farmers. Around 1,200 farmers from Tamil Nadu participated in the march in Delhi. The group stripped themselves and covered their body parts with skulls and bones of their fellow farmers who had committed suicide in the past years. Pon Radhakrishnan, a senior BJP leader and union minister, went on to condemn the protests, stating that the protesters had degraded the status of other farmers in Tamil Nadu. And he also went on to allege that the protesters had financial backing of some political parties from the state. The farmers of Tamil Nadu have suffered huge losses owing to severe drought intensified by the cyclone Gaja. Crops and cattle were lost and many farmers were displaced. Despite this, the BJP leader did not extend his support to the farmers of his state. A recent study from the Indian Institute of Management, that's the IIM Ahmedabad, found that there were potentially 9 lakh preventable unplanned cesarean section deliveries out of the 70 lakh deliveries that happened in private hospitals in the year 2016. The study quotes, a natural birth in the private facility costs on an average ₹10,814, while a C-section costs around ₹23,978. The study also states that while C-section is an important surgical intervention during childbirth, performing it when it is not required can impose a huge burden on the mother and child, apart from being heavy on the pocket. With the announcement of Pradhan Mantri Jan Arogya Yojana, that is to provide a cover of Rs 5 lakh for poor households to seek secondary and tertiary care in any government or empaneled private hospital, it is important now more than ever to evaluate whether the private sector is really capable of being an effective partner in providing health services for the citizens of this country. Mumbaikars are up in arms over the soaring electricity bills over the past month. The power distribution, which was earlier under Anil Ambani-led Reliance Infrastructure or RINFRA, was recently taken over by the Adani Electricity Mumbai Limited, or the AEML. Agitated consumers have taken to Twitter and social media to vent out their frustration. AEML responded to the spike in prices by claiming that RINFRA had filed a tariff petition to MERC, Maharashtra Electricity Regulation Commission, on December 22, 2017. When Adani took over on August 28, 2018, the tariff revision order was issued by MERC soon after. Hence, the authorities from Adani claim that this tariff increase has no correlation with Adani taking over and it is only a coincidence. While this may very well be a coincidence, it is still a fact that tariffs have doubled. Privatization of electricity has been pitched on the grounds of improving facilities by increasing competition. But the fact is that privatization is bound to only increase prices over a period of time. That's all we have for you in today's Daily Roundup. To keep yourself updated on the latest news, do log on to our website www.newsclick.in. You can also follow us on our Facebook page or visit our YouTube channel.